Hey, new day, welcome back. Before we get started, I've got something to talk about. So I'm going to be working on the inside of this boat a little bit for this section up in here by the windshield. I might stay up there a little bit just to take advantage of the sun bouncing from there into my face. But then I'm going to hop down here and I'll be walking along this little crawl thing here, a little elevation, to get up to the rest. Now, before I do all that, if you recall, I raised this boat up so that I didn't have to bend over nearly as much to get down in this area. Now I get to do the fun thing of taking it down. So 1 second, bam! It's like magic. Speaking of magic, Bubble Stash IPA. I think this is a Washington brewery, Hop Valley. What they do is they get kind of scientific with it. They freeze dry their hops the moment they get them. That way they're not breaking down and deteriorating while they're being stored in refrigeration. So let's see if I can do this here. Anyway, what their claim is that they're able to keep more of the flavors, the resins, flavonoids, and all that natural in the hop so that you get more flavor. I don't know if that's true. I mean, one beer to the other, they all seem like they're doing something different that makes them unique. Pardon me, I just don't like all that foam. Okay. Yeah, that's healthy. I like that. Nothing too sharp, nothing too crazy. It's got a little bitterness to it. It's got some tropical, like passion fruit, maybe a little bit of guava. Not a lot of pine, although there is that aftertaste, you know, about 2 seconds after you swallow it. So that's kind of nice. Yeah, good shit. All right, Bubble Stash by Hop Valley. They've got about 6 of these out. And they do different things with them. All of them have the freeze-dried hops, so give it a shot, see what you think. All right, I'm going to get into this. Leave me alone. Oh, that's good. Somebody recently suggested that I took way too long to do all this, and that I could have saved a ton of time had I just sanded it. Now, I've done a number of boats, probably 2 or 3, that I've done one side buffing, and somebody else has done the other side sanding. You've seen it. I videoed it. Make sure that we all saw it, because I was tired of having that argument. I do not think that all boats can recover with just a buffer. I do, however, think... And right about here, the wind noise took over. Basically, 98% of the boats that I see can come back with just a buffer and the right compounds and a little bit of love. And yes, there are times you've seen me do it where I take some sandpaper and I might clear up some things, maybe some ghosting left by a decal or some hull numbers or something like that. But for the most part, I just buff them out. Now, in my rant about somebody making a comment, I decided that I should just not talk and pretend like the camera's not there. So that's kind of what I'm going to do for the rest of this. There may be some times when you might see some dialogue come up, and I might talk over it like I am now. Obviously, I'm not used to just sitting here and not saying anything. However, for the most part, what you're seeing is just me going at this with some Super Duty, then some Heavy Cut, and then some Perfected. And you can see how long it took, and I might have some things to say later when the wind noise possibly dies down. Anyway, I apologize for the lack of something to block the wind noise. I didn't have it with me, and I did not expect it. Today looked like a beautiful day. However, Mother Nature reminded me that it's just spring and it's not summer. A little bit later in the video, you'll see what I'm talking about. Although, who am I kidding? Out of the last hour and 28-minute video that I did, the average view time on that, guess, take a wild guess. That's right, 6 minutes. An hour and a half long video. All that editing, all the camera movement, blah, 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 blah. 6 minutes. I don't know what to say at that point. I mean, yikes. I mean, I know I'm not all that compelling, but I kind of hope that I could hold your attention for a little bit longer than that. 6.5 minutes. Man. Maybe if I wore a bikini, maybe some hot pants, would that do it? Blah. Okay, just take that out of your head. Focus on the fucking boat, and maybe stick around for long enough to enjoy a beer for love of Pete. So, good lesson learned. Shake up the Super Duty. It's dang. It's the heat's helping the oil separate from the particulate. Alright, so I've got this little line down here and blah blah blah. Again, I'm doing this like you're not here, so I don't care. Watch, don't watch. Don't matter to me. Clearly, I'm still salty about the viewer retention on that last video. However, I did want to tell you that I'm going to turn the volume down a little bit just because I don't think it's fair for you guys to have to listen to the buffer and wind noise. Now, don't get me wrong, if you're a detailer, it's just par for the course, but it is rather annoying, especially when this is also another... Oh, did I lose you? Shoot! We're at the 6-minute mark. I assume I just lost half of you. Anyway, sorry, this is the sarcastic side you... Well, I was going to say you don't get to see, but you guys have seen it. Who am I kidding? All right, fine. I'll talk a little bit through this. Let's see. What am I doing here? Obviously, it's kind of a pain in the arse to get around those fittings into the boat. It'd be nice if I had the spindle extension nuts. Or a 12-inch buffer pad. That'd be kind of nice, too, I suppose. But luckily... Prior to all this, I used that little mother's ball or the flitz ball or whatever it is on the drill to get in behind the places that I knew that I couldn't get with the buffer. So I already took care of that. This is just Super Duty, so I'm just trying to score up the surface and break the oxidation off of the, quote, fresh gel coat, hopefully lying somewhere beneath it. And you can usually tell when you've gotten through the oxidation, the reflection of the sun comes back a different color, and once the product starts to break down, it leaves a very unique kind of sheen on the surface, and it lets you know that it's just cutting into fresh gel coat. Regardless of what people think when you're like, oh, I've used compound, you're not getting all the oxidation out. Stop. Absolutely stop. Don't get me wrong. I know people that learned to buff and never learned to buff right are probably not getting the oxidation off. Now, you would be correct thinking, why is that guy putting 67 all over the boat? Well, you're actually close. It's a bottle for 91, but they look the same, and it's a Meguiar's product, which is made by 3M. So technically, it's a 3M product. It's not 67 or 91. It's actually 3M's Heavy Cut. At this stage, Heavy Cut's next, so that's what I'm using. And then pretty soon, I'll probably show you how I'm using it. In fact, I'm definitely going to show you how I'm using it. Pretty much exactly the same way as I used Heavy Cut or Super Duty. Except for as I finish out, I'll treat it a little bit more like a finishing product instead of just looking for the cut and the reflection and the color match. I'm actually looking for a decent reflection and a decent color match from a bunch of different angles. Yeah, so I'll leave you alone for a sec. Hey, you think now would be a good time to remind people to wear sunblock? Or a hat? Either one. right about here, somebody came up and asked me a question. So instead of violating their sense of privacy, and I thought I'd just mute the conversation. Hope you don't mind. Now Hero is trying to offer a public service announcement and let you know that although foam is fairly safe, doesn't leave a lot of scratches on your boat, the backing plate is just rubber. So that spinning and having an effect on the gel coat that you're not trying to get can be really bad. It creates a lot of heat in, just like that. Imagine I snap my fingers at that point. So I'm just kind of trying to tell you to watch it here. Make sure you have some lubrication on that other surface. Make sure there's compound on everything, and don't hang out there for very long. Light touches. You've already hit it with the wool pad and the Super Duty and the heavy cut. So just light passes. Okay? Be safe. Try not to burn your boat or your finger or gel coat or anything like that. Now that part in front of the windshield kind of where my head's blocking, I'll be getting to that a little bit later. So as I'm working on this part of the boat, I am thinking to myself ahead of time, I'm going to be moving the shine a little bit more into that oxidized section where I've got that bottle sitting. So I try to carry my work a little bit past that. So instead of just the left and right that I'm kind of focused on, the 5 or 6 inches right in there, I go a little bit past that, knowing that I'm going to have to blend that top piece into what I'm doing currently. Anyway, the more I can do now on that top piece, the better, so that when I'm on that top piece, I can get right back down and smooth it out and blend it all into the side, which in my head are two separate pieces, even though it's all just one big white piece of gel coat. not sure if you're able to see the difference in this cleat compared to what it used to be, but this side looks really nice and this side kind of looks meh. So if you've got Super Duty on your pad and you've got a little piece of metal, little, don't be doing like a pontoon boat or nothing. You come up with looks cool. Turns it a little bit black. Nice surface now. Starting to produce a little bit of shine, and with any luck, should be able to pull out some of this. There, here we go. Try some cross cutting. That seems to work out fine. So all those cuts went this direction, now I'm going to get some to go in that direction. Thank you. that's a lot. Yikes. Okay. Might be here for a little while. That's a lot of compound. Hot day.
He goes, sorry for the distraction.
Living in a boatyard, you know, people show up and they're like, hey, what's this? What's this? Actually, it's an interesting story. The guy I was talking to said that he had his boat re-gelcoated 2 years ago. It's a black, white black boat. And it's faded out tremendously. So I went around his boat and I'm looking at it. Nothing in what I've seen indicates that it's a re-gel coated. I think what happened was a bunch of douchebags wet sanded the boat, probably polished it and told him they redid his gel coat. The guy said he paid about 10 grand. I told him if he ever wanted to hunt these idiots down, I got a couple of pieces of ordnance that he's more than welcome to use. That sort of stuff pisses me off. So, then I have to be the bad guy and tell him, hey, I realize that you just paid us a lot of money to have something done. And I'm telling you that it was pointless. So I'm now going to charge you a crap ton of money to fix that. It's a hard call to make. I mean, it's never something that you want to tell people. But we've all been hosed before. And we've all found somebody who is willing to grab us by the hand and kind of walk us through what it takes. That's all he needs. So if you're a young detailer and you occasionally get calls where people are like, I don't think it's worth it, blah, blah, blah. It's not my fault you don't know. But you educate them, you grab them by the hand, and you try to help them. If they want to listen to you, help them. If they don't want to listen to you, screw them. It's like that with everybody. I'm no different. I'm telling me to do something, and I don't want to hear it. Walk away. But if I'm listening to somebody and they seem like they want to help me, you can imagine how much I hate these snaps and that I can't take them out. Whenever you're forcing something into a place, it's always a good idea to go slow as you can. Now I can kind of fix this part where I got the two sections coming together. I am going to speed this up just a little bit. I'm not, you know what? No, I'm not. I'll be right back. If people are only watching 6 minutes of the video anyway, what do I care that somebody has to put up with a whole bunch of boring, boring video of a guy doing basically the same thing every 3 feet? I'm not actually trying to be a jerk. I decided to be lazy and not edit very much. So I apologize. Every now and then, this is what you get. Can't always be, you know, flashy.
Oh, this is interesting. I don't know if you can hear this. So sometimes when I'm buffing on the side of a hole, you'll hear a tick, 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 tick. You'll think it's the buffer. It's not. My backing plate is having some separation issues. So eventually I'll have to get a new buffer wheel going. But for right now, this is working. So.
I have no idea.
Okay.
I didn't touch it. Thank you. Gotten better, but this area hasn't learned that you have to pay to play. So to kind of break the ice and get people more interested in this work, I'm doing it for a little discount, not a lot. As an example, if this was going to be like a $90 a foot boat, I might charge 50, just until I get to the point where in this area people are starting to talk. And once they start to talk and you build a reputation, well then you're not so much charging for the work as your time. Realistically, how it's looked at. These people have the money, obviously. They got these really nice boats. But the people that have screwed them over in the past have given them shell shock. And so if I come in here saying, oh yeah, $80 a foot, $120 a foot, they don't trust me. I wouldn't either. I wouldn't trust anybody. We talked about this briefly a moment ago. So I have to, in a new location, play that way. I have to pretend that you don't know me. I don't know if I'm the guy. I don't know if I'm the guy. I'll give a good old try. If everyone's happy, yeah. Usually everyone's happy. Okay, I need a drink and a break. As an example, this is just one pass with Super Duty. So all these little crevices and the contours and stuff with these snaps and this tank lid. I mean, come on, just get with it. I know nobody likes to admit that they've been doing it the wrong way for 30 years, but You've been doing it the wrong way for 30 years, I'm sorry to say. I mean, at one point people thought the Earth was flat. I know, people still think the Earth is flat. That's just because there's idiots born every day. Anyway, with just Super Duty, guys, and this is the first pass, one, you know, decent pass, but it's just one pass. Now with the heavy cut, let's see what that looks like. My phone overheated because it's sitting in the sun, and I guess it was working really hard. Anyway, it stopped working. I didn't really, sorry, just technical issues. Anyway, I don't think anyone could have sanded this to this level in the amount of time that it took me to do this. Last time I had a guy sand a boat on the other side while I was buffing it, his palm sander shaved these into little razors. Like it cut the tops open so they weren't rounded, they were just sharp metal, all of them. Not to mention he dug into the trim, he dug into the gunnel. So I'm just gonna say it, I'm done listening to anyone tell me that you can polish a boat the same speed or faster with sanding. Now there are times you've seen me do it where I've maybe got hull numbers on the boat, maybe I'll just sand that really quick just to get it out of my face, but after that I'm gonna grind and I'm gonna get a little dot of sun and I'm gonna keep going on the next boat. And this guy's going to be thrilled, so. Anyway, that's all I had to show you, and it wasn't really much. And I'm sorry that my phone got too hot. I'll talk to you later. Bye. And then after perfected, I mean, come on. It's just, it's not even a question. Here's the other thing. If you're a wet sander and you don't like what I do because you don't think that it's possibly as good as what you do, show me. Show me that you've tried what I do first, then come and complain. And honestly, when I say show me that you're doing what I do, use a wool pad made by 3M. Use the products that I use and spend the time that I spend. Use the techniques that I use. And if you don't think that it's better, maybe then I'll buy you a beer. I'll concede. Maybe for you, it's not the right thing. But in, almost 20 years of doing this, I haven't seen any evidence to suggest that wet sanding is a faster way to get this done without destroying, the snaps, the trim, the gunnel. You're going to be sanding this? Who's going to be sanding that? And make it not look like it got sanded. That's all I'm saying. I know, broken record. I just keep saying it, but someone said something in a comment recently and kind of got under my nerves. Under my skin. Anyway, I'm done for tonight. I'll come back, work on... I left this. I didn't finish this. I wanted you guys to see this tomorrow, so I'll set the camera up. The sun will be more in this line, so you can see the reflection. And then, of course, all this horse crap. And a little swim step. After that, though, it'll be done, and here's what she looked like before. And... bing! So, fine, I did it. Mostly because of you guys, mostly also because I felt bad joking about this guy's outdrive. It's not his fault, he didn't know, he's not a marine engineer. Couldn't possibly have fathomed how this would hold up. Sorry, it's not nice of me. Anyway, sun still hasn't kicked off yet. I mean, you can kind of see it's blue-ish. But we're still, I haven't touched this, and that looks pretty decent. So that's kind of what I'm talking about. If I get into this, I'm going to fool myself. Partly because I've been doing this so long that I'll just think, oh, I've nailed it. Don't let a boat fool you. And that's all they want to do is fool you. So, again, I haven't touched this. And this is just the type of light we've got. So if I get into this and I think I'm doing a really good job, and then the sun comes out clear and it looks like ass, I'm going to... be a little grumpy sauce. Anyway, just letting you know, I didn't shift the guy. I felt kind of bad about what I said, and I felt bad about the fact that you guys saw what I said, and shut up.
Thank you.
then this happened. Yay. Thanks for watching all 6.5 minutes. I appreciate it.